time for minor skirmishes is over. We now prepare for war. The villain Longshanks is poised to cross the river forth and threaten the town of Stirling with a force of men-at-arms, heavy cavalry, and a multitude of archers. Our newly formed army marches southward to establish our own base and attack the English before they can ready their troops.
The time has come to take the offensive. The English have a fort near the town of Stirling. If we can defeat the English here, they may think twice about their invasion of Scotland.
To win, destroy the English tower to the west.
Scout cavalry are poor fighters, but they can see you at a great distance. You can use your scout cavalry to explore the rest of the map and find the English. Before we attack the English to the west, we need to build up our forces. Have your villagers start gathering food.
You found some sheep? Sheep are a good source of food, so send them back to your town center
and assign a villager to gather food from. You can specify a location for new units to gather by selecting a gather point. For villagers, click the town center and click the set gather point button. Keep making villagers at your town center until you have 10. The more villagers you have, the faster your resources will come in. You can gain more food by building fishing ships. To create fishing ships, have your villagers build a dock in the water to the south. The hill with the dead tree protects the only access to your town.
It'd be a good idea to build a watchtower on this hill once you advance to the feudal age.
Use your villagers to build a mill near your forage bushes.
Your villagers, you can use the town bell to garrison them in your town center. Click your town center, then click town bell. Good! You defeated the English assault. If you have villagers in your town center, ring the town bell again to send them back to work.
Kid. Here.
Love.
Now that you've reached the feudal age, concentrate on making some soldiers to fight the enemy. You will need at least 12. An English outpost. You know what to do. Knock it down. Until you've got an army of about 12 soldiers. Remember, you can upgrade your militia to men-at-arms at the barracks. You should always upgrade soldiers when you can afford them.
Thank you.
You've eliminated the English soldier. Now destroy that tower, and our victory will be complete.
Great job!
You've destroyed the English camp. The Battle of Stirling is sure to end in victory for the Scots. Now that you know how to build up, advance through the ages, and find and fight your enemies, you have all the basic skills you need to play a random map game, the most common type of game in Age of Empires. Don't forget, keep exploring the map. Stirling was our first great victory. Even as we held the coastline, word came in that the Stirling Bridge had been held by a force of Scots led by the mythical knight, of whom so many have spoken. Now we know his name, Sir William Wallace, the Hammer of the English. Edward Longshanks names Wallace a traitor and a criminal, but Sir William replies that he cannot be a traitor, since he never swore fealty to an English king. With Wallace leading our armies, the men fight with renewed vigor. Perhaps the tide of our misfortunes is about to turn.